Hello everyone and welcome to my review of the SIIG HD Capture Slim Box, a budget video capture card. There's not a lot of info about this device online, so I thought I would just give you my thoughts and impressions and put them out there for everyone to enjoy. I have to say, first impressions are decent despite this hideous generic box art with this army dude and race cars driving or whatever. It boasts decent specs. It can record HDMI, composite, and S-video with all the included cables at 1080p, 720p, or 480p. It can record directly to PC, Mac, and even Android tablets and smartphones. And it's got pretty much everything in the box that you'll need to get started. However, I will say this as a disclaimer right up front. This thing is incapable of recording at 60 frames per second. So if you need something like some application or game that demands fluidity, just skip. Go ahead and give this one a skip. Let's kind of go into, I guess, like a brief unboxing. This is the device itself. It's very small. Here's a DualShock 4 controller for scale, right? It's very small. It fits between the hand grips of the DualShock 4. It's a mini unit. It's very small. You might mistake this for like a DVI to HDMI converter box or something, right? It's super tiny. SIIG makes a lot of different components, but this is very tiny, a pretty fashionable looking device with its, you know, soft touch plastic and glossy plastic on the edges. It looks nice. It's unobtrusive. The only thing I don't like about the small format is there's no real dedicated place for it on my entertainment stand. I pretty much just pop it out when I need it and then shove it into a junk drawer when I'm not using it. So that's, I guess, the only downside of its small stature. But like I said, it includes the ability to record as video and AV. It comes with this cord, this breakout cable you plug into this, what looks like a mini USB or micro USB. Maybe something proprietary. It just kind of fits in there. Not flush, unfortunately, but it just kind of plugs in there. And then these little dongles hang off, and you plug your shit in, and you're good to go. It also includes this breakout cable for Android recording. So you need like a USB wall wart or any other 5-volt source. And that's how it gets power from that. So anyway, that's kind of like a crappy unboxing. It also includes this disk of software. But you can download all the software you need either from their website or off the Google Play Store if you decide you want to record with Android. One thing you'll notice is that it lacks an HDMI pass-through. So if you'll need to purchase a separate HDMI splitter, such as this one. If you intend to use this for game recordings, you're going to need something like this because even though the output of this thing to the recording device is crystal clear, like it looks great, the output introduces about a second or more of latency. So for any gaming application, that's just not good. That's not going to help you out. The software bundled with it is basic and easy to use. I'd assume that most people just need something to get raw video files with, so for that purpose, it works fine. But then comes a hurdle. The device actually has, like I mentioned, I think earlier, hardware encoding on board, which is great because it takes the processing strain off of whatever recording device you're recording to, but the resulting files are strange. If you record on a PC, you'll get an M2TS file, which is incompatible with the video editing software I use, Sony Vegas. If you record on something like this cheap Android phone that I've recorded to for demo purposes, you'll end up with something that looks like an MP4, but doesn't behave like one. Also incompatible with my software. I'm not sure what they're encoding with. I thought it was H.264, but whatever it's encoding with, it's not spitting out a file that's easy to use. So that's kind of another hurdle that comes with this device. The only way that I've found to make sense of the files is to convert them using Handbrake, right? And I don't know what's causing this, but I strongly dislike having to re-encode a video I already spent the time to record, right? It's just like another extra step that I think is unnecessary. One thing I have to say is I am impressed with the fact that I can record video to a low-end, like this is a first-generation Moto G. It's got like no power. It's like a Snapdragon 400 processor in it. But even with that, it records, you know, full like 1080p, 30fps video like a champ. The advantage of that, of course, that I didn't mention is that this is great if you don't have or want to record to a PC. It can simplify the recording process if you're not like a PC user or if you just kind of like to live lightweight. Although that begs the question, if you don't have a PC to record to, why wouldn't you just use the native recording features of a PS4 or Xbox One, right? The PS4 can save 15-minute videos with a push of one or two buttons retroactively, you know, after the fact, requiring zero additional setup or forethought. And I know PC gamers also have access to NVIDIA Shadow Play and the AMD software equivalent. So since free video recording software like this exists ubiquitously, does a budget capture card device like this even need to exist? And I would say for most modern cases, no, not really at all. But if you take a look at this video example, the PS4's native video share feature tested on Yakuza Kiwami running on a PS4 Pro. While the game isn't too terribly impressive graphically, I'd say, it includes some nice effects here and there, as well as decent color palettes and, you know, to draw conclusions from. Also, I'm in the middle of playing it and I really like it, so it's kind of, you know, worth testing out for this example. I mentioned streaming earlier, I think, but I kind of am against recommending this device for streaming. And the reason for that, you know, there's a few reasons. First off, it's incompatible with a lot of broadcast software like XSplit and stuff like that and others I've tried. The included VivaCap software actually includes the ability to stream to Twitch, YouTube, and I think one other, but it's just woefully lacking in features for everything but the most bare-bones stream. And not only that, but the quality is just hot garbage. No matter what settings I tweak, no matter how much I increase the bitrate in the settings, I got this strange flickering that would occur every once in a while that would cause these really weird color issues when I tried to stream to YouTube. And YouTube streaming, by the way, was the only thing I could get to work. I couldn't even get it to work with Twitch at all. The whole thing was just like a piss poor experience. I don't wish it on anyone. It was not good. Like, do not, if you need a streaming device, do not buy the SIIG HD Capture Slim Box USB 2.0. It's like the full name. It's just not great. So at this rate, you know, like, let's think about all the negatives. It can't capture 60 FPS. It lacks HDMI pass through. It can't encode properly in H.264, or even if it is, it's encapsulating it in weird file formats like M2. TS. It can't beat a PS4's native and free video tools or PC's free and native video tools, and it can't even stream worth a damn. So after all that, you're probably thinking that the SIIG HD Capture Box is a waste of $60. That's the price, by the way. It's $60. And in many ways, yeah, it is. It is a waste of money. But I can think of a fringe use case. What if you wanted to use this to capture, you know, old, like, classic games? What if you needed to record from an older HDMI compatible thing like a PS3 or Xbox 360 that didn't have native video capture functionality? Or, you know, just something like a PS2 or PS1 game that you wanted to review and never got around to. You know, and obviously the classic Sega and Nintendo titles. So that's where this device could ostensibly come in handy, right? There are slightly cheaper options available in the SD capture, you know, world, but not many are as flexible or as easy to use as the SIIG. The box won't improve the shoddy look of older console composite output, which frequently looks messy. I'll throw up an example on the screen. But S-video capture in comparison looks like razor sharp. So if you have an older console that's S-video output, you know, it'll look good. The colors won't be amazing or anything, and there's some tweaks you can do in editing, but it looks pretty sharp. So here's the bottom line. The SIIG capture card, you know, it's an odd duck with more cons than pros, honestly. But if you're looking for an affordable way to record old consoles, it's not terrible. You can also use it for the occasional new title that has share features disabled due to copyright issues with music, like Gundam Versus on PS4. And that's it. Overall, I'd recommend the Hophog HD PVR Rocket if you need something, you know, with one button functionality and something that's portable. The SIIG HD Capture Slim Box is cheap, but you'll end up paying the difference in time spent and frustration. Anyway, thanks for watching, everyone, and have a great day.